and we need to look for honor that comes from man. So not man, from God only. So every time we go to the office or anywhere, we need to just do things that are right. Whether they like it or not, we need to do things that are right so that we will receive that honor from God. And there is an honor that comes from God, and that honor is amazing. It's amazing. It's beyond what man can give you. It's beyond what anybody can give you. And we need to seek that kind of honor. And the Bible says in Psalms 8, verse 5, says, God has honored us, given us glory and honor. He has honored us with dominion and authority. In Psalms 145 also, he says that he has given us, let's move to Psalms 145, verse 5 to 9. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and the two-edged sword in their hand, to execute vengeance on the nations and punishment on the peoples, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute on them the written judgment. This honor have all his saints. We have the honor to, we have the dominion and authority to execute vengeance on the devil. You know, now our fight is not against flesh and blood. We have all this. That's the honor God gives you. The honor God gives you is when you pray, your prayers are answered. The honor God gives you is when you are sick and you go to God, He heals you. The honor God gives you is when you are jobless and you ask Him, He gives you the best even though you don't deserve it. And if you are living an honorable life, no matter what situation, God will come to back you up. He will be able to trust you. And He will not be able to trust an honorless person. See, He will not be able to prosper an honorless person. If you are not an honorable person, He will not be able to trust you with riches. If you are an honorless person, you will use those riches to do ungodly things. That is why it is very important that you start honoring God in everything. See, the Bible says, be faithful in little things, and He will make you ruler over much. Most of us care about the big things. We may not get involved in adultery or fornication. We may not get involved in a big thing. We may not go and, you know, rob a bank or, you know, steal from someone. But there are other small issues. Like last time we were talking about the papers we take from our offices, the pens you take from your office. Those are not for you. That's for the office. We need to be honorable in those areas. Even from the hotels, people take hangers and I heard it from someone, and towels, you know, those are not for us. And the other day we were traveling in the aircraft, and we saw a lady, her bag fell. Suddenly all the plates and spoons and all that from the aircraft were in her bag. And she was ashamed. She was ashamed. And when you walk in that kind of thing, the Lord is saying, you will put yourself in a position where you will be lightly esteemed. The Bible says, if you honor God, He will honor you. But if you despise Him, you will be lightly esteemed. And this lady was lightly esteemed because she was doing an honorless thing. And everyone was laughing at her, and she had to pick all those things and put it in her bag. That's not an honorable act. So, in everything, we need to find out whether we are doing the right thing or not. The Holy Spirit is there. He always convicts us. When the Holy Spirit convicts us, don't do it. Don't do it. And so we, as children of God, we need to portray that example. We have to be the ambassadors of Christ on this earth. We have to be that example. People will be looking at us. And if we are not honorable, then who are they going to learn from? And so we need to walk in that honor. It's very, very important that our words also, we be men and women of our word. If we say yes, it's yes. If we say no, it's no. We stand for our word. It's very rare to find people who are people of their word. And you know, in the olden days, we used to hear about people, even not even Christians, people who would be men and women of their word. I said it. That's it. Whether I have to kill my son, I will do what I said. Haven't you watched movies? We have watched movies where these politicians or some honorable men, no matter what happens, they will do the right thing. I remember watching some Malayalam movies where the son becomes a criminal and the father is a sub-inspector. He is a police officer and he is an honorable man. He doesn't scheme or plot. He just gives the right punishment to his son. These are honorable people, but we don't find such honorable people these days. People scheme and play politics and do all kinds of things to get their promotion. And you know, a judge who is an honorable judge, he deserves that position to be honorable in that position. But if he is scheming and plotting to be a judge, will he be an honorable judge? We have the military. They have, like in America itself, they have like 4 stars, 5 stars. It shows what an honorable act they have done. They would have done amazing things. But then there are soldiers, you know, people who scheme and plot and get those stars. Are they honorable? No, they wouldn't have done a thing to get those stars. So the honor God gives you, no man can take it away from you. There is an honor which God can give you, which man can never give you. But on this earth, there are some places where I may not be honored by human beings. For example, in my office, I do my work well, I work hard, I may not be honored, may never be honored by them, but God will honor me. My just reward comes from God. I can, in my office, I don't easily get promoted like that because I don't know how to scheme and I don't want to and play politics and all these kind of things. But God gave me a scripture, your just reward is from me. And when He gives it, it is going to be 100-fold, you know, and it's going to be amazing. But when you play politics, scheme and plan and do all kinds of things and get it, you may even be in trouble. And when you are in trouble, when you call on God, He may not be there to help you. So it's always better to be in the place where God puts you. So God can honor you to the point where men can't stop it. That's the way He honors you. And last time I defined honor as a keen sense of ethical conduct. But actually, the real Bible honor, the meaning of Bible honor is carrying weight or making heavy. Carrying weight. An honorable person is a person who carries a lot of weight. Or you know, is a heavy with glory, heavy person. So, like, his word carries weight. His words are honorable. So if you want to honor God, you will give importance to His word. His word will carry weight in your life. His word will be heavy in your life. His word will influence you. But if you do not honor God, His word will not carry any weight in your life. So check yourself. Does the word of God carry weight in your life? When God says don't do that, do you obey that or do you do what you feel? If God's word carries weight in your life, then you are honoring God. What about Abraham? Abraham honored God to the point where even when his son was asked to be sacrificed, he honored God by obeying and taking his son and sacrificing him. And he didn't have to sacrifice, but he honored God to the point where his only son, after how many years he got that son, Isaac, even when God asked him to sacrifice, he was ready to do that. That is why God calls him a friend of God. And God honored Abraham. He's called the father of nations. We who are in Christ Jesus, we are the sons of Abraham. That much honor was given to Abraham. And I know about Kenneth Copeland. He was saying that when he started learning about obeying God and all that, they took a decision. God, whatever we see in this world, we will obey it. Whether we feel like it or not, if it says something, we will obey it. That's a major commitment to make. That's not easy. It's a major commitment to make. They, husband and wife, took communion and they decided that whatever is said in this world, that's what we will do. And it came to a point where when they came to one scripture, it said, do not owe any man anything but to love one another. That means you are not supposed to borrow. And in America, it's not easy to live without borrowing. You all know that. Everything is on mortgage, the house, the car, the furniture, everything. And you cannot, and in those days, during, immediately after the Depression days, it was not easy to live will not have a house, I will not have a car. But they decided, if God's word says that do not owe any man anything but to love one another, we will not owe any man anything. And they honored God by His word, they preached it, they had a lot of persecution, they believed it, but God gave them the best. Today they are having an international ministry all over the world. You know, they didn't start with money, they started with debts. They had a lot of debts. But as they honored